For someone who has been in the computer business for more than a decade, way too often I see people underutilizing their Windows machines. Today I'm here to change that and show you how to unlock your PC's full potentials. Hey Earthlings, welcome to another YouTube video. Today I'm going to be teaching you guys how I set up Windows 11 laptops and desktop for maximum performance. This guide is for those who are setting up a new Windows machine, but still apply if you're already using a Windows device. At the end of this video, I will be sharing 3 tips that will help keep your computer running optimally for many years to come. So don't be quick to click off. Before we proceed, make sure to smash that like button and ensure that you're subscribed. If you're not, hit the subscribe button right now and turn on your post notification button. To start off, update your system. Step 1. Update Windows, drivers and apps. Keeping your Windows, drivers and apps up to date is crucial, as it not only brings in new features and security patches, it also helps increase performance sometimes. To update your Windows, search for Windows Updates and click on it. Click on Check for Updates and this will check for available updates that you can download. To update your drivers, right in your Windows Update menu, find the Advanced Option menu and click on it. From there, navigate to Optional Updates. This offers extra updates that don't appear in your regular Windows updates. If you don't get driver updates using this method, simply search for your laptop model space driver space download on Google. This should show you your manufacturer's website in where you can find your necessary driver updates. To update your apps, search for Microsoft Store, navigate to Downloads and click on Get Updates. Frequent updates are like regular exercises for your computer, as they help keep your computer in top shape, ensuring that your device runs smoothly and efficiently over time. With this done, we can now move on to the next step. Step 2. Download proprietary softwares. Proprietary softwares are specialized programs provided by manufacturers to control and manage various hardware functions. Many top-end manufacturers have their softwares, like Dell's Support Assistant and ASUS Armoury Crate, allowing users more fine controls like adjusting performance profiles, regulating fan speeds, or controlling RGB. Sometimes they even support undervolting and overclocking. Usually, these softwares come pre-installed on Windows laptops or pre-builds. But if you have a custom build, you would need to find each software that controls each hardware. If you have a laptop which doesn't have any, try searching up the model number to see if it comes with one, as some don't. However, if it does but you can't find it installed, here's how to go about it. Go to Google, search for your laptop or pre-build model, and name space support and click on the link that's from your manufacturer. If you have a custom build, do the same with your part model, e.g. ASUS ROG blah 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 space support. Then navigate to drivers and softwares. Here you can manually get your drivers and your proprietary softwares. Click on software/utility and in there, you should find your proprietary softwares for your laptop or pre-build. Read the description of each software and download the ones that you think are necessary. After installing them, open each of them and find out what they do and how to use them, as this might significantly improve your experience with the computer. In my Lenovo Vantage software, I switch power modes when I'm about to game to get the maximum performance and increased fan speeds. And other softwares control things like RGB and speakers. Now we are moving on to the next step. Step 3. Always remove bloatware. For those who don't know what bloatware is, bloatwares are just extra softwares that come pre-installed on your devices. Most new high-end Windows laptops and pre-builds are loaded with it, cluttering your system with apps that you don't need and end up using valuable resources. The Windows operating system is particularly very fond of this. You might see apps like your Microsoft Suite and your antivirus pre-installed on a brand new Windows device. And what hurts me the most is that they usually come with trial versions that only lasts 30 days, after which you'll be disturbed with prompts to pay for the full version. Yes, even antiviruses count as bloatwares, as long as you didn't ask for it and you don't need it. I mean, you already have Windows Defender, which is free and capable and is already pre-installed on your Windows device. To remove bloatware on your Windows 11 device, head to your search bar and type installed apps. Click on the option that says system settings and from there, identify any bloatwares that you do not need. If you come across softwares that you do not recognize, don't rush to uninstall it as it might be a proprietary software to your computer. Instead, search for the software's name online to learn more about it. And once you're sure it's unnecessary, you can go ahead to uninstall it. By removing all of these bloatwares, you're freeing up lots of resources, giving you performance gains when you need them the most. Step 4. Turn off core isolation. Core isolation is a Windows 11 feature that uses virtualization for extra security to fight against attackers. And since this uses a bit of resources for that, turning it off gives some extra performance. Some users have reportedly seen up to 10% increase in performance gains in games. To do this, go to your search and type in core isolation. Click on it and disable the option which says memory integrity, and that's it. After which you might be required to restart your computer and it will be permanently applied. If you're thinking, would you trade your security for some performance? Don't worry, if you're being targeted, it will not be the memory integrity option that will save you. Step 5. Install your essential softwares. With bloatwares out of the way and updates complete, it is time to install softwares that you actually need. Whether it's your game launcher, your productivity apps or your creativity softwares, install only what is essential, so other apps don't take up valuable resources like space and processing power. Now let's move on to something that slows your system down, but most of you don't even know. Step 6. Reduce your startup apps. Let's talk about startup apps. Like the name implies, startup apps are apps that starts up when your system starts up. The more startup apps you have, the slower your system starts up due to having all your startup apps start up when your system starts up. I hope you guys enjoyed that tongue twister. So what I personally do is that I try to keep my startup apps as lean as possible. And I only turn on apps that I want to auto-launch with the computer. Every other thing stays off. To do this, search for Task Manager or press Ctrl plus Shift plus Escape. Then navigate to your Startup tab, then right-click to disable any apps that are not critical to your daily use. These simple steps would help keep your computer's startup time fast and stop unnecessary apps from being open in the background without your knowledge. People who have had their Windows machine for a while will have more startup apps, as over time, as you install more apps, you'll notice an increase in your startup apps. So make sure to keep checking back regularly and disabling those that you do not need. Now let's move on to the next step. Step 7. Set your refresh rate and resolution. For the best visual experience possible, make sure that you're running your monitor or your laptop screen at the highest refresh rate and resolution that it can handle. Many people don't realize that your screen's refresh rate can make your computer feel faster. I remember when a friend got a new laptop and he brought it over to my place. As soon as I collected it to use, I noticed it felt slow and laggy. Immediately I went to his display settings and checked his refresh rate. And alas, he was running on 48Hz, even though his laptop supported up to 120Hz. I then switched it over to the 120Hz option and immediately the difference was clear. It felt way smoother than before. Uche, you owe me one for that. This is a big issue that many aren't aware of, and new high refresh rate users might not even know about it. Imagine having a 165Hz display only to be running it at 60Hz. Please double check your settings and make sure that you're running your computer at the highest refresh rate and resolution that it supports. To check for your resolution, right-click on your desktop, select Display Settings, then go to Advanced Display Settings. Choose the highest recommended resolution and refresh rate that is available to you. While scripting this, I realized my main monitor was on 120Hz and it supports up to 144Hz, so I just switched that. Shame on me. Also, start planning to get a high refresh rate display if you don't already have one to get that buttery smooth feel. And next we have step 6. Choose the right performance mode. Windows 11 has a built-in power mode feature which lets you choose between balanced, high efficiency and performance depending on your needs. Higher end gaming laptops and prebuilds also come with proprietary software which lets you control these power profiles. So if your system comes with one, do use that as it controls the system settings. To switch power modes in Windows 11, go to your Windows search and type in power mode, then click on the system setting option and set your power modes. Alternatively, use your manufacturer's proprietary software to set your power profile. Remember to set to quiet or power efficiency when you want to get the maximum battery life at the expense of performance. Choose the balanced mode for a mix of performance and decent battery life. And if you want the absolute best performance possible, even at the expense of your battery life, then choose the performance option. Don't have your system set to best battery when you're looking for the best performance. And also don't have your system in best performance mode when you're looking to conserve battery life. And at this point, you have completely set up your computer for the maximum achievable performance without overclocking. If you don't already know what overclocking is, please stay away from it. All that is left for you is to make sure that your system is running on par with other systems with similar specs. Which brings us to step 9. Run a benchmark test. Now that you've had everything set up properly, it is time to test your system's performance. Run a CPU benchmark and compare with other systems that are similarly specced. If you have a gaming device with a GPU, you should also run a gaming benchmark, or you can use in-game benchmarks. If your score is considerably lower, then something is wrong. Please send it back to the manufacturer or test for faults. Now here comes the bonus tips that I promised you guys to help your system stay in peak performance for years to come. Number 1 is regular maintenance. I recommend servicing your system at least twice a year, keeping it dust free, performing regular virus scans, and cleaning up unnecessary files. Number 2 is stay updated. Make it a habit to check for driver and software updates periodically, as this not only improves performance but also keeps your system secure. Number 3, monitor your system. Always keep a close eye on your system and look out for strange signs, as early detection can be what saves your system from the graveyard. And there you have it guys, a complete guide on how to set up your new Windows 11 PC for maximum performance. If you find this video helpful, smash that like button and do subscribe for more tech tips. Also, if you have more tech tips you could share, do leave them in the comments for others to learn from. Thanks for watching, until the next time. At the end of this video, I will be sharing 3 tips. I remember when a friend got a new laptop and if you're not, click on the subscribe button. Hey!